Good morning, students. Today we are going to do chapter number 3 of Literature Reader. The name of the chapter is Gopal and the Hilsa Fish. This is a story about Gopal, who is a court jester. A court jester means a person who makes other people laugh by telling jokes in the court of a king. Gopal worked as a court jester in the court of King Krishnachandra of Nadia. So here in this chapter, we will learn how, with the help of his intelligence, Gopal solved the problem of the king. So in this chapter, there are various characters present and there are some scenes given to us, and we will see what happens in all the scenes. So we'll start with the chapter, which says Gopal Bhar. The name of the character, the first character, the important character, that is Gopal Bhar, who was a court jester. As I have told you, a court jester is a person who makes the other people laugh by telling jokes in the king's court. He was a court jester in Bengal and he used to work in the court of Raja Krishnachandra of Nadia. So he was known for his intelligence, and he was known as a man who brought cheer and laughter, who brought joy to everyone with all his wit, means all his intelligence. Okay, so the characters are, firstly, the narrator. The narrator is a person who narrates the story. Courtier 1, courtier 2, courtier 3. Courtiers are the persons who sit in the court of the king. Gopal Bhar, the main character of the story, and Raja Krishnachandra, the king, in whose court the Gopal Bhar was working, and a woman. So in the first scene, firstly, the narrator is describing about the first scene, that what happened there in the first scene. The narrator is telling that it's the monsoon weather. The monsoon weather has started. And the monsoon weather is the season of all kinds of fish. In the monsoon season, all kinds of fish are used to eat. All kinds of fish are used to make as their food. As the people from Bengal, they love the fish. And in the monsoon season, it is the season when there are all kinds of fishes available as food. But everyone in Bengal usually like to buy Hilsa. Hilsa is a name of a fish that is considered as an expensive fish, and which is very pleasant, which is very yummy and tasty to eat. That is usually in Bengal. And people brought Hilsa, people buy Hilsa, they used to cook Hilsa and they eat Hilsa, and every time they used to talk about Hilsa. Means, first scene mein humein bataya ja raha hai ki monsoon season, jo ke fishes ka season mana jata hai, usme Hilsa hai, jo Bengal ki ek important fish mani jati hai, jo ke kehte hai ki bahut hi costly hoti hai aur बहुत ही delicious to eat होती है, और लोग हैं जो हिल्सा खरीदते हैं, उसको cook करते हैं, उसको eat करते हैं, और पूरा time हिल्सा के बारे में ही बातें करते रहते हैं. Now in the first scene, the king Krishnachandra is it's a part of king Krishnachandra who is saying Hilsa, Hilsa, Hilsa. He is tired of talking. He is saying that I am tired of talking about this fish. I am tired about listening about this fish. कि मैं थक गया हूँ हिल्सा के बारे में सुन सुन के. No matter wherever I go, whoever I meet, and everyone is talking about Hilsa. Raja Krishnachandra, he is tired of listening about Hilsa, as everyone, wherever he goes and every person he meets, everyone is talking about Hilsa fish only. Gopal, the jester of the court, he says that he is saying this to king, that your majesty means, he is saying this to the king, that isn't it natural ki ye cheez to bahut natural hai, kyunki because this is the season of hilsa fish and people are bound to talk about that, kyunki ye hilsa ka season hai to isliye people are jo usually uske bare mein baat karte hain. Krishnachandra is saying, the king is saying that this discussion about Hilsa fish is very boring and tiring. He's asking Gopal if you can do something so that people stop talking about Hilsa. Ki kya tum aisa kuch kar sakte ho ki log hai jo Hilsa ke bare mein baat karna band kar de. Gopal says, but sire here means giving respect to the king. This word is used to give respect to the king. Gopal is saying, but sir, I'm not clever enough to change the nature of the people. Ki main itna clever nahi hu ki main logon ki nature ko change kar sakun. But haan, ek din ke liye I can stop them from talking about Hilsa, but I'm not sure about this. So the king says, well, if you are able to stop the people from talking about Hilsa for one morning, I will give you a reward for this. कि अगर तुम successful हो जाते हो लोगों को बात करना बंद करवाने के लिए Hilsa के बारे में, तो I'll be rewarding you. Gopal, he becomes happy. He joyfully says, as you wish, and tomorrow I will make sure that nobody will talk about Hilsa or any other fish in your court. कि कोई भी आपके court में अब Hilsa या किसी fish के बारे में कल morning नहीं बोलेगा. So this was the first scene where the king demanded Gopal to stop people talking about Hilsa. Now in the scene 2, we will see what is happening. In the scene 2, what is there in the scene 2? Narrator is explaining. The narrator is telling us that Raja Krishnachandra arrived the court in the next morning and he saw that Gopal is not present in the court. And so he got angry, he got annoyed ki Gopala jo usne apna promise nahi rakha and he is not present to stop the people about talking regarding Hilsa. And he is afraid of, he is wo dar raha hai ki agar usne logo ko chance diya bolne ka, so people will start talking about Hilsa again. And then after that, when he is thinking of all these things, then he noticed that a strange woman is coming to his court, is coming inside his court. All the courtiers, jo log present hote hain court mein, that are the courtiers, all the courtiers, they are whispering, they are talking to each other slowly and they are laughing and asking, who is this? When they see the woman is coming in the court, they are asking to each other, ye kaun hai and kya ye hamare town mein se hai? Krishnachandra, he is talking to himself, the king is talking to himself and he is thinking, what a strange woman is she. She is very big, she has long and big arms and her arms are having big hair and she is having very big feet. Humongous means very big feet and she is wearing a very dark blue colored sari and nobody is able to see her face because she has covered her face with a veil. Veil means usne ghungat kiya hua, isliye koi bhi uska face hai jo wo nahi dekh sakta hai. The narrator is telling us that the woman is walking like a dancer and she, uska jo walk karne ka way, she's just looking like a dancer who is dancing and her ankle bells, matlab usne jo paon mein apne feet mein payal dali hui hai, they are making all odd and strange sounds and the courtiers are murmuring to themselves. Wo ek dusre se kanafusi kar rahe hain, dheere dheere bol rahe hain. Courtier one is saying, what on earth can this bizarre creature be? Ki ye strange creature kya hai, kaun ho sakta hai? Courtier two, it isn't anyone we know, that we don't know who is she. And the courtiers three is saying, no one in our village is bold enough to wear these kind of things and walk the way she is walking. Means wo keh raha hai ki hamare village mein koi bhi itna bold nahi hai ki is tarah se aise kapde pehen ke aaye aur is tarah se chale jaise ki ye women chalti hai. Now courtier one is saying, maybe the Nawab from the nearby kingdom has sent her. The courtier one is saying, maybe the king from the another court, the another kingdom, he has sent her here. The king is asking curiously, the king is asking her, who are you and why have you come here? What is the reason of you coming here? The narrator is telling us that the woman stays silent. She is not replying to any question that is being asked by the king. Courtier 2 is saying she cannot be a part of the dance troupe. And king is saying, don't be afraid, please speak up. Ki daro mat, tum bol sakti ho, tum bolo ki tum kaun ho, kahan se aayi ho. The narrator tells us that when Krishnachandra says these things, the woman pulled her veil, matlab usne apni sari ka pallu wo apne face pe aur zyada close kar liya, apne face ko aur zyada cover kar liya, and the bangles she is wearing that jingled on her fat wrist, ki uski bangles hai unke awaaz aa rahi hai khanakne ki. The king is getting irritated now and he is asking him in an irritated manner that, tell me, what do you want? I have many works to do and you are wasting my time. When you are not speaking, you are wasting my time. So please tell me, what do you want? Courtier 3 is saying, maybe she is unable to speak. He is telling this to the king that maybe she is unable to speak. Whereas the courtier 2 says, might be she is unable to hear and speak both. And courtier 1 says, I guess she is an escaped क्रेजी मीन्स कि वो भाग के आई है कहीं से, वो पागल औरत है. नरेटर इज सेइंग दैट एवरीवन इज गेसिंग हु इज द वुमन एंड हु शी कुड बी, एंड शी इज स्टैंडिंग ओवर देयर, शी इज सेइंग नथिंग, एंड द ओनली साउंड्स दैट शी इज मेकिंग दैट आर ऑफ हर एंकलेट्स एंड दैट आर ऑफ द जिंगल ऑफ हर बेल्ट. उसकी पायल और उसकी बैंगल्स की ही आवाज है जो वो कर रही है, उसके अलावा वो कोई भी और आवाज नहीं कर रही है. मीन्स जब कोई उसे कुछ पूछ रहा है तो वो कोई आंसर नहीं कर रही है, सिर्फ अपनी एंकलेट्स और बैंगल्स को हिला के वो आंसर दे रही है. कृष्णचंद्र एक्सास्पिरेटेड, द किंग गॉट एनॉयड एंड ही सिंग आई डोंट नो व्हाट टू डू बट आई एम बाउंड, आई एम अ किंग एंड आई एम बाउंड कि जो भी मेरे कोर्ट में आता है तो मुझे उसकी हेल्प जरूर करनी है बिकॉज आई एम द किंग, बट अब ये मेरे को कुछ बता ही नहीं रही है तो हाउ एम आई एबल टू हेल्प हर, राइट. सो द नरेटर टेल्स अस हियर दैट ऑल द कर्टियर्स, ऑल द पीपल हु आर प्रेजेंट इन द कोर्ट, दे फेल्ड at the tricks to make the women talk. They are unable to make that women talk and nobody succeeded in making the women talk and the only sound she is making that was of her giggles. मतलब वो धीरे धीरे हंस रही है, यही आवाज है जो आ रही है, और या फिर उसके फुट और उसकी रिस्ट की जो जैसे एंकलेट्स और उसने बैंगल्स पहनी हुई है, सिर्फ उसकी ही आवाज आ रही है. कर्टियर वन इज आस्किंग आर यू मैड. The narrator tells us that the woman shook her head. She says a no with her head only. She moves her head and says a no. Courtier 2 asks her, are you unable to hear us? कि क्या तुम हमें सुन नहीं सकते? Narrator says, the woman shook her head again. The courtier 3 says, do you think this is a joke? तुम्हें क्या लगता है कि ये मजाक चल रहा है? And in this way, the narrator tells, in this way, the whole, this thing goes on for the whole morning and the king became annoyed, exhausted. The king is saying, enough is enough. I am tired of you. You are not telling me anything. Come back the next morning, but किसी को साथ में लेके आना so that he can explain it to me that what do you want? Then I will look it after that. Narrator says, that the king got up from his chair, his throne means his chair, and everyone got up with him. Everyone stood up. This is the matter of respect, that when the king stood up from the chair on which he sits, all the other people, they also stand up for showing respect to the king. Everybody started leaving the court one by one, but the woman, she was standing there only where she was standing. The king asked her, there is no point of waiting, अब और वेट करने की कोई मतलब जरूरत नहीं है, कुछ फायदा नहीं है पॉइंट वेट करने का. Can't you see कि ये सेशन ओवर हो चुका है, माई वर्क फॉर दिस सेशन इज डन एंड आई हैव वेस्टेड माई एंटायर मॉर्निंग ऑन यू एंड ट्राइंग टू मेक यू टॉक. द वुमेन इन अ डीप वॉइस, द वुमेन देन फाइनली द वुमेन स्पीक्स एंड शी सेज, बट माई मॉर्निंग हैजंट बीन वेस्टेड, कि मेरी मॉर्निंग वेस्ट नहीं हुई है. नरेटर सेज अस दैट जो किंग है वो बड़ी हैरानी से उस वुमेन को देखता है और उसको लगता है कि ये जो साउंड है, ये जो वॉइस है, बड़ी ही पहचानी हुई है, जानी पहचानी हुई है. किंग फाइनली कम्स टू नो दैट इट्स गोपाल्स वॉइस एंड ही इज आस्किंग गोपाल, what does all this tomfoolery means, what does this silly behavior means, you have wasted whole of my morning. And Gopal, he throws off his veil, he opens up his veil and he says, have I wasted your morning, sir? The king says, yes, because I have so many works to do it and I have so many works to attend, but I was not able to do any work just because of your silly joke, of your silly behavior. Gopal tells him that, but sir, nobody mentioned about the hilsa fish this morning. Isn't that what you wanted? कि किसी ने भी आज हिलसा के बारे में बात नहीं की, क्या यही वो चीज नहीं थी जो आप चाहते थे कि कोई भी हिलसा के बारे में बात ना करे? कृष्णचंद्रा, the king says, I did, but he's saying that कि हाँ मैं चाहता था कि कोई भी बात ना करे, पर Gopal says, I only did what you asked me to, your majesty. Gopal is saying to the king that मैंने सिर्फ वही किया जो आप चाहते थे. I distracted everyone so that they forget to talk about hilsa or any other fish. I was just distracting everyone so that they will not be able to talk about any fishes. Krishnachandra started laughing and ही सेड यू हैव मेड अ स्पेक्टेकल ऑफ योर सेल्फ ऑल दोज बेंगल्स एंकलेट्स एंड सारी, मतलब तुमने अपना मजाक बना लिया इन सारी चीजों से. गोपाल सेड आई सक्सीडेड इन वॉट आई सेट आउट टू डू. ही सेड आई गॉट सक्सेस इन वॉट एवर आई वॉन्टेड टू डू. नरेटर सेज राजा कृष्णचंद्र लाफ्ड एंड ही वॉज रिकॉलिंग द गोपाल्स एंटेक्स दैट मॉर्निंग. एंटेक्स मीन्स द एक्शंस दैट आर फनी एंड दैट आर अनोइंग. ही वॉज द किंग वॉज रिकॉलिंग द गोपाल्स एक्शंस दैट आर अनोइंग एंड प्लेफुल and he was laughing. Then the king said to Gopal that you succeeded and I have to think about your reward. कि अब मुझे तुम्हारे reward के बारे में सोचना पड़ेगा जो मैंने बोला था कि तुम्हें reward मिलेगा अगर तुम successful हो जाओगे तो. Gopal says that please don't give me Hilsa fish my king. And at this everybody in the court started laughing. So this was all about the story. In the story what we have seen that intelligence matters a lot. Intelligence and wittiness of a person matters a lot. Matters a lot. With the help of your intelligence, you are able to solve all the problems. So you have to be wise. You have to think about the problem and then you have to think about the solution. In an intelligent manner, you can solve all the problems very carefully and you can get rewards also, as Gopal got the rewards by success, by getting success in what the king has told him. So now we will see the exercises that are given. Firstly, answer these questions. There are 6 questions given that are dependent upon the story itself. You have to read the questions and then you have to tell about, you have to give answer to that questions. Secondly, think and answer part. Here, these questions are for you only. You have to think about the situation that is given to you and then you have to answer that situation. Like, imagine you are Gopal. But means, ab aap apne aap ko imagine karo ki you are Gopal aur aap kya logo ko distract karne ke liye isse achha plan soch sakte the? Aur agar aap soch sakte ho to ki kya plan ho sakta hai? Similarly, the second question. Third is, understand the structure. As we have seen, this was a play. Every play has characters and that is divided into acts which have scenes. The characters who appear in one scene, they may or may not be present in the another scene. So there are 2 questions given. Do you think all the characters are important in the play? Ki play mein sare characters important hote hain, aapko ye lagta hai? Which ones do you think are the most important in this play? Isme sabse important kaun se the? And what is the role of the other characters? You have to tell the role of the other characters present. How many scenes does the play have? Isme kitne scenes the? What is the importance of stage instructions in brackets? कि जो stage instructions होती हैं brackets में जो दी गई हैं उनकी क्या importance होती है आपने ये बताना है. I hope you have understood the chapter carefully. Thank you.